in, tuning in, getting the energy flowing in your subtle bodies, your emotional body. We want to access your mental body. We want to access your physical body, your very cells, your mental field. And we're channeling through to get the momentum going. In, moving, calling to the surface that which you are ready to release and plug and pull and move through. fill in all the gaps, your connection with you, your connection to your soul, your connection with this universe, your connection and love for yourself, with every other living thing. For your growth, for your development, for your well-being, for your manifestations, for your creative influence, just channeling through. All right. Up here, some holly berry incense matches. My intention with this video is simply to give you a little ASMR, a little tingle. A little energy reset through your relaxation. crystal tapping, and I'm working with a selection to work with correspondence regarding heaven and earth, matter and spirit, subtle and tangible, mind and body. So these are the first ones we're working with, a golden healer and a ametrine celestial. And I'm just going to be tapping around you, clearing these points, these channels, supporting flow, supporting your manifestations, supporting your lessons, your development, your ascension, your progress. Correspondence of action and daydreams, you know. Channeling through beyond time and space to anyone open to receiving. Tensions of balance, alignment, flow, standing in a abundant stream of resources, of spiritual connection, of whatever is right for you at this time. Shift to these stones, an optical calcite, and an apopalite cluster. Hope you can see. Can be working around the crown, down to the heart. Clearing this channel. Remember, all channels are unidirectional, right? Is that how you say it? Bidirectional. It always goes both ways. And let's say, for example, the mind of the universe, the mind of all, the love of all fuels you, supports you, and you in turn support it by following your heart, your path. physical connection. We have this tiger's eye and the natural citrine point. So that's what they look like. We're going to be focused, excuse me, from the heart down through. Correspondence points to the body, to your actions, your path, the tangible path, I mean, your relationships, your physical manifestations. Confidence, your authenticity, your sense of self. Steel and golden healer. set an intention to allow the correspondence, the significance of feathers and air and wind and blowing to lighten our stress, lighten our burden, to create movement in our energetic system, to support the processing of any emotions, the stirring of inspiration and creative flow, the release, the receiving, the expression, the processing of thoughts, the release of thought patterns that do not serve us, and really anything that you might be benefited by. Through the auric field, the energetic field, and start in the eyes, connecting to the subconscious, the subliminal mind, the mental burden as well that we've kind of taken on. So we're going to work first, kind of focused in the pineal gland. If you are curious, this isn't ethically harvested. Collected, I should say, excuse me. Turkey feather. Gifted to me. Just focus. Your perception off, your senses off on how you see yourself, how you see the world, giving yourself a fresh chance to change your view, to find deeper appreciation or problem solving or personal realization. Thoughts, solutions, release, a bit of a surrender. So you don't have to overthink everything. You can let some stuff go. Have a little trust, a little faith in some things working out as you chill or as you focus on things. Calming down. There's so much in the collective consciousness here to serve you, already set up. Infrastructures, webs, points of connection, all here for you to access. Right. Emotional body, the intention to connect with the emotional body, just bringing flow, letting those emotions process, move, Let them hit you like a wave, and let the tide carry you out or knock you under. Just feel, is what I mean. Just feel. Validate. Release. Don't attach. Acknowledge, but don't attach. Just let it move through you. Get ready for the next feelings. Dust through your physical senses, your receptive palm, going up your arm, through your shoulders, into your heart, out, dominant channels, and out, your dominant palm point, your expressive palm point, just being in. All around the auric field, clearing all projections, all malicious, manipulative energy, anything that does not belong to you, that does not serve you. Just sweeping away. Everything move, defragment, shift, fall to the foundation of your growth, of your development. I'm going to focus in the pituitary gland, activating between the pineal. This flow, this connection. Down to the thyroid. Harmony. harmony, balance, your body, focusing on the energetic connections, communication all throughout the body. May your signals be received precisely in alignment. May your hormones, let's say, be balanced. May your immune system be balanced. To ground all of your higher points of connection, whether that's in your dreams or your daydreams or your meditations or just your intentions, your plans, your goals, to ground them into your experience. We're just going to be focused on combing through your auric field, clearing all projections that have been sort of directed to you by others. That is not of your truth, is our intention, releasing that which is not of your truth that others have sent to you, whether they were well-meaning or more malicious. We're also going to be addressing any sort of, like, I'll call it holes or tears in the auric field. Any energy vampire sort of, forgive this word, but like leaking, like leakage of energy. So we can direct that all back to you. So you feel energized, recharged, empowered, clear, and not influenced by the environment around you in a negative sort of way. Alright. So start with just tuning in, feeling around the aura, the space around you. It might be just centimeters from your body or feet away. The intention here is to clear, 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 and locate any area that needs addressing. Starting over your head, shoulders, down your back, down your arms, and chest in front of your body, down your legs, all the way. Removing all limitations here in the physical realm to comb through and clear anything that may be stuck a little more deeply, anything imposing on your connection, your true connection with the environment, with circumstance, with how you feel about things, with where you are in relation to your goals. Sometimes these projections make things feel far away, or this auric influence makes things feel far away when really they're right here. Just mending through the aura. A little deeper here to your auric perception. Just smoothing, kind of like reworking it, almost like dough, or stirring the little, what are those called, like snow globe sort of looking trinket. comfort, feeling of being held by yourself, by your connection to everything, by your heart, by your inner child, or holding. So you feel like what has your back is truly supportive, not vindictive or assuming, not projecting, not putting you into any space that, again, is not aligned to you. Knowing that what supports you, what you allow to have your back, truly on your team, truly in your corner, holding you in your divine empowerment, holding you in your best self, let's say, whatever that is, right? But we know what we mean. I'm gonna connect with images of love, abundance, flexibility, clarity, and a little bit of warrior too, and just influence the field around you to hold whatever quality is most supportive for you, wherever you might be at this time. Command the aura to take on these properties. To take them on. To hold this sacred space for you around yourself. Using a little hohari frankincense. We're just gonna adorn your temple with this oil. On the temples. Like two open windows, carrying through the light, the movement of air, the ventilation, the circulation, the movement of thought. Really focus on the pineal gland. Space and your subtle senses, your intuition, your inner vision. Mm-hmm. meridians, and again, the auric field, the outer fields, as within, so without, as without, so within, working through correspondence. So your aura focus today has a deeper context to it, right? Bring a little heat to this frankincense oil. Through your emotions. And to help through the process. Working in the aura is a very powerful way of performing, or a powerful step, or piece, So if there's any emotions that come up, I want to use the correspondence of our opal healer to just allow those emotions to flow, know that they are clearing, purging, sort of, releasing, moving. The tide has to go out, carry it out, take you out sometimes with it. Focus on your emotional healing. Whatever you've got going on in your life. Like a wave coming up and out. And bringing in and out. And in and out. Love up. The orange field. Seeing your aura in a beautiful holographic sheen and iridescence, almost metallic, otherworldly sort of color play. To keep you protected mentally, emotionally, spiritually, communicating to the mind of yourselves. Stay protected, to stay balanced, to keep you in perfect wellness. On bottles, spraying your auric field with some lovely intentions, of course. So we're going to first start with this desert rain. And we're going to set an intention to let the rain wash away any stress, any fear, any anxiety, any thought pattern loops we're kind of stuck on, any urgency that is not helping, any confusion, any doubt in yourself, any lack of confidence. Sending this rain into the core, so around you, in all perceived directions, and within, and just let that rain, that mist, that fog, that foam, that wave, that river. Carry it away, releasing all that stress, releasing all the tension, all the thoughts and loops of thoughts we get stuck on. We're not really problem solving, we're just holding ourselves in a chaotic or tense state. So we just want to let that wash away, that rain. Call in the guardians. I'm going to use the directions where I'm at now, but you know, we'll just have to use that correspondence. So we're going to focus to the north and call in your guardians of the north. Your grounded, tactile guardians, your powerful guardians, your strong, stable guardians to the north. We're going to call in your guardians to the south, your transportational guardians, your like fire, movement, transforming, transformational, excuse me, guardians, supporting your change. I'm going to call in the guardians to the east behind you here, calling in that inspiration, that clarity, that wisdom, and to the west, your emotional spirit. History, to your truth, to your ability to transform, your flexibility, the release of a rigidness, the release of fragility, your power, your light, your shadow. Intellect, your thought, your divine intellect, inspiration, your confidence, your trust, your knowing, your spiritual connection, your emotional compass, just lending to the foundation. Front. Moving this through your aura to energize you. An offering to your vital force. listen to the solar plexus. Sacral, pulling up, uplifting our mood, down to the root, uplifting, sharing, such a vibe. Really calling in your power, really unlocking your potential, claiming ownership, sovereignty of yourself, of your life, of your reactions, of your methodology, of your practice. You energetically speaking, please be careful out there, right? In the real world, don't play in traffic. But energetically speaking, no one can take anything or send anything to you that you do not receive. You are a force to be reckoned with, and I say that playfully and humbly. Perceived in you, by you, every moment of every day. Never forget who you are, what you're capable of, and how loved you are. Western red cedar, and we're gonna do this all around the like upper shoulder area. Sweet, safe space around you, being held, being guarded, being loved, being cared for. Healing on so many levels. Tuning into the softer side of yourself so you can be gentle. loving through you, caring, cheerleading in your own corner here, and held as well by the universe. You are part of this beautiful, divine web of connection, of limitless potential, of unconditional love, playing your part by simply being yourself. So say sleepy time spray that we're gonna go. Your dream processing, your dream work, your deep rest, your ultimate comfort, your protection while dreaming, easily drifting off, easily lulled, lulled to sleep through your breath, through your focus on comfort. Floating in the ocean, in the sea. Stepping down a flight of stairs into sleep, into rest, into rejuvenation, into regeneration, into healing, into processing, into these very sacred spaces. And just a blessing for your sleep, for your rest, for your nap, for your daydreams. The sacred kupal behind, in front, side, above, below. hope you enjoyed our little time together today. Thank you so very much for allowing me to share a little piece of your path, and thank you so deeply and truly for being such a significant part of mine. From the bottom of my heart, I bow to the divine in you and I, and to this interesting connection that we share. So very much love to you, of course, and namaste.